What up, I do? Welcome to Premier Lawns video. This isn't my usual style of video. Now, I'm going to say that I'm really struggling with something and I need your advice. Let's go and have a chat. Today's video, something completely different. I'm really, really struggling with some of my work. It's been a bit of a, excuse me for family, it's been a bit of a shit show this year. Before I get into that, now, my problem is that I've got too much work. Now, I know there's gonna be people watching this saying, Robbie, F you, I don't have enough work. And I know what it's like. If you don't have enough work, it can be really, really stressful. So if you don't have enough work and you want some advice, I run a really good community on Facebook called the Premier Lawns Community. Come and check us out. I'll leave a link down below. There'll be guys on there that will help you grow your business. But the problem with me at the minute is just because of the weather we had in March, it was an absolute shit show. The start of the year started well. January wasn't bad. February was actually pretty warm and mild for February, very warm and mild. I know a lot of lawn care companies were out renovating lawns personally. I think it's a bit early to be doing it, so I held off. Then whenever March came, we had the snow, we had the ice, we had the rain, it just didn't seem to stop raining. And then after that, just as it was starting to normal out, I got the flu, got a really, really bad flu. I'm still not right, my throat still feels sore, but you know what it's like if you're self-employed, you can't be sick. So I'm just gonna say self-employment is hard at the best of times. However, if you're sick and you can't get the work done in the weather, you can't get the work done, then it can be hard. And as a business owner, you put yourself under a lot of stress. Now, something I will say is with the app that I use, the Manage My Time Jobber, I'm able to pull out of that email list. So I was able to email customers directly from MailChimp that's connected to Jobber and email customers and just tell them that I was running behind. For the most part, I must say, my customers have been fantastic and nearly all of them, thankfully, have been happy to wait on me. But as a business owner, you still put yourself under that stress, and the more stressed you are, then the less you sleep, and the less you sleep, the more stressful you get. So at the minute, I'm getting up at 6 in the morning and I'm working at 10 o'clock just every night, and then I'm working at the weekends. So for that matter, because I couldn't do any work in March at all, because March was just a write-off with the rain, the snow, my sickness, everything just went on hold. So I've been turning down thousands of pounds worth of work, which isn't ideal either. I have a lot of people, this time of year, I get the most customers in, and I just don't have enough time to see new customers, look after my existing customers. And also, Jason's a really good lad, but he also needs, obviously, a bit of training and just to keep him right. So I'm really, really struggling to find the time to do it all. Silver Lake. Nice full box. People watch the videos and think I have all the time in the world, when in actual fact I don't. I don't have any time. So a lot of people contact me just day and night. It's actually got this stage now with my telephone number on my website. People just phone up all day long looking for free advice. And if you answer the phone, you say, look, do you request a quote? No, we just want advice. Look, if you want advice, go to my YouTube channel. It'll only take a minute. Just give me a bit of advice. And it just goes on like that, on and on. So it's at the stage now where I can't answer the phone because people are just torturing me. So I don't know why or not I should take the number off my website, but then that's going to scare customers away. But on the same token, I'm not answering that phone anyway. So I don't know, do you take that off? Do you just take it off the website and make it that it's harder for people to contact you? The way I prefer my customers to contact me is through my website with the request a quote feature. I have it all tied off in Jobber. I ask them a load of different questions and then I can filter out the good and the bad. Before I wrap this video up, and if you've made it this far, happy days. Don't forget to smash that like button for me. I'm going to give a shout out to another channel that I watch on a regular basis that talks about the ups and downs of running a business, and he's a really good storyteller. His videos are really good. Rob from Maxwell's Garden Services. I'll leave a link to his channel down in the video description. So if you want to check his channel out, if you want to find out about the highs and lows of running a business, go and watch that. See you in the next video.